Yes, sir. Now, today, we're going to talk about former 1017 artists and chanting. Now, it is something that's been going on for the last couple years with Gucci Mane's label 1017. Now, it's said that there is a 1017 curse. And it's very interesting that the next rapper on the list name is Enchanting, goes by the stage name of Enchanting. Now, that's interesting with her being a part of this said 1017 curse, because if we look at the root word, if we look at the etymology of the root word enchant, enchant means to practice sorcery or witchcraft on. Right? And in figuratively speaking, so it's like a double speaking, right, with this person, right? So they was telling you that she was enchanting, right? Meaning that she was delight in a high degree, charming or fascinating, you know, meaning attractive, right? But they was also telling you as well that she was having witchcraft practice on, right? To bewitch, charm, to cast a spell. And as we can see, man, with these events trickling down, man, and these folks gonna keep on signing to him. But anyway, man, let's dive in on the numerical synchronicity between this situation, man. Now, first and foremost, the rapper Enchanting, right, who first name Channing, right? So her first name was actually Channing, right? And she went by the rap name Enchanting. Right. But her birthday is October 9th. Now, I want y'all to look at this, man. So her birthday is October 9th. Now, it's very interesting that that happens to be the anniversary of Yale University. Might I add that her birthday was on the 322nd anniversary of Yale University, which is home of Skull and Bones. Order 322. Now, it's very interesting that the span of Enchanting's life on this planet, on this plane, was in fact 320 months and 2 days. That was the span of her life. So I'm not sure if this was really her birthday, whether this was the birthday that it got changed to. Anybody that really knows these people in real life can attest to this. But if it is, it's just very crazy that it has this synchronicity. So let's first talk about the Skull and Bones synchronicity with this situation. Let's keep on diving deep. Like I just said, Skull and Bones, Order 322, the span of her life, 320 months and 2 days when her birthday is on the 322nd anniversary of Yale University. They just had their 322nd anniversary last year, which was her last birthday that she seen in this life. Was that anniversary? That was her last birthday that she got to see. But come on. Right? Because she also passed away, man, June 11th, 2024. Now, breaking that down, we get 61 date numerology and 41 date numerology. Now, taking her full name given at birth, Channing Nicole Larry equals 61 in the Chaldean cipher. Then she ended up passing away on 61 date numerology when Skull and Crossbones equals 61. So this is why she passed away on this date numerology, with this span of life, with this lifespan, right? All about Skull and Bones. So this was a Skull and Bones ritual, but that's not the only kind of ritual it was. But first, let's continue. Let's continue with the Skull and Bones connections, right? We also have 41, just like Skull and Bones also equals 41 in this same reduction cipher, right? So we have Skull and Crossbones and Skull and Bones. Come on. right? Because even Gucci, looking at these people, they're following, the people that they're following, the followers, the posts, the amount of posts, because you do know that a lot of these people, followers are bots. They're botted, right? So they be having specific numbers when their names are in the headlines. They always have a specific, they're always at a certain number at the time that something big happens in their career. So you see Gucci has 833 posts, right? You have the 83, the 38, then the 33, right? Then you have, then he has 17.3 million followers. When Yale University, that's what we just discussed with his artists, right? Birthday is on the same birthday as Yale University. So it's very interesting that Gucci has 17.3 million followers on Instagram at the time when Yale University equals 173. But let's keep on going with this Skull and Bones connection, man. Because keep in mind, this is also Channing's birthday. Not only is it Yale University's birthday, but it's also Channing's birthday as well. So she passed away on the 8th month and the 3rd day of her birthday and Skull and Bones' birthday. Well, excuse me, Yale University's birthday. When even October 9th was on a day leaving, 83 days left. And that's the day that Yale University was founded. When Yale University equals 83. This is why I said that it's very interesting that Gucci, his 833rd post was actually saying RIP to this individual right here, this pretty young lady right here. And y'all see that she got the all-seeing eye right on her neck. You see what I'm saying? But Yale University, in other words, it was also called the Brotherhood of Death, when Brotherhood of Death also equals 83. This is the day that she happened to pass away on. The date numerology that she happened to pass away on. Murder by numbers. Even the word murder equals 83. Just like this movie, once again, I know y'all tired of me referencing it, but it has a prevalence in these situations, and it happens time and time again. So this is a perfect reference point because we clearly see the number 8, right? The number 8 here, the number 8 here, and then the number 3 here to let you know, in fact, that this is being practiced. Murder by numbers. And even murder equals 38, the reflection of 83. So let's continue to dive deep on the number 38 now. Because if you actually watch the movie Murder by Numbers, in the corner, the teacher writes on the board a date 3/16, right? And these dates are interchangeable. It's not about the dates themselves. It's about the numbers that revolve around the date. Did I say that right? It's about the numbers that revolve around that date. Yeah. So flipping that backwards, we have 16/3. This is why they wrote it on the board in the movie Murder by Numbers, because the number 163 is the 38th prime number. And that's the day that Enchanting ended up passing away, on the 163rd day of the year, which is the 38th prime number, when her first name, Channing, equals 38. And she was a rapper when rapper equals 38. She has now joined the long list of rappers that die with the number 38 surrounding them. Right? But come on. Now, I'm gonna bring this connection to you, and it's gonna make sense as the video progresses. Now, she also passed away. Keep in mind that her birthday is the same day of Yale University's birthday. Keep that in mind with all these connections that surround Channing, aka Enchanting. Now, she passed away on the 35th week and the second day of her age. And also Yale University's age as well. When Michael Jeffrey Jordan equals 352. Now, Kenfo, what the hell does Michael Jordan have to do with this situation? She was not a rapper from Chicago. She's from, what, was she from Memphis or something? I don't know where she's from, actually. Oh, matter of fact, she's from Fort Worth, Texas. It just said it. Yeah, Fort Worth. She's from Fort Worth, Texas, Kenfo. What the hell does Michael Jordan have to do with this? Just sit back for a second. Just sit back in your seat for a minute, right? Let me just make these connections. Now, 352, right? Just like Michael Jeffrey Jordan equals 352. Now, keep in mind, Michael Jeffrey Jordan also equals 109 in the reverse reduction. When once again, Yale University's birthday is October 9th, 109, just like Michael Jeffrey Jordan. So here is the ode that the character Michael Jeffrey Jordan gave without us knowing, because it's the ode that these people give to these secret societies, right? Without us knowing, right? Because even the day that Michael Jordan introduced Air Jordan to the world, the day that it began was November 17th, 1984, which was a leap year that year. So that very day was the 322nd day of the year when Michael Jordan started Air Jordan. So in a sense, this has nothing to do with her, but it also has everything to do with her at the same time, because these are the connections that our world is surrounded around, right? Look at these parallels, man. 322, and how long was her life? 320 months and 2 days, man. This is why these artists get sacrificed on the days that they do. These are the odes, these are the tributes to these secret societies, right? Now, who knows if Michael Jeffrey Jordan, was that a strategic name choice given to give this same tribute? To give this same as that tribute, right? Michael Jeffrey Jordan equaling 109, and then he starts his company on the 322nd day of the year. So it seems as if this numerology, right, is giving ode and giving tributes to these secret societies, man. But come on. Come on, because Gucci Mane, let's talk about Gucci Mane and his connection to Skull and Bones. Because his birthday next year leaves 322 days remaining. Remember, we talked about this Skull and Bones synchronicity with the people that surround Gucci when we talked about Shawty Low, when Shawty Low was born on March 22nd. Y'all see what's going on, man? Do y'all see what's going on, man? We talked about this when we talked about Shawty Low and the Skull and Bones connection. March 22nd, when Skull and Bones is the order 322, right? Then he was born in the year 76. Just like Skull and Bones equals 76. So this is what I'll be asking is, was his birthday changed, or did he just happen to just be born? Was he just born on that day, and then the day that he was born just happened to end up the reason why he would die later on in life? I mean, what are we in a simulation? What's going on? Because I'm starting to believe that this is 80%. A lot of this shit is 80%. Just the way of the world that we live in is based on numerology. And then the way these people die, these people do be sacrificial lambs. But the way these numbers work out, it's no way possible that humans could be doing all this by themselves. It's no way. But anyway, Shawty Lowe's death will also show you that Gucci has something to do with it as well. Just looking at the synchronicities with Shawty Lowe, because Shawty Lowe was born in the year 76 and he died at the age of 40 when Gucci Mane equals 76 and 40. So yeah, man, there's something going on with everybody that's surrounding this person. Everybody that's surrounding this person, they either die or they go to jail. Now, I got a lot of people saying, man, that's just because Gucci signed a lot of trench babies. Gucci signed a lot of trench babies. That's why. That's why, because he's signing people from the hood. And that would be the perfect cover-up, right? That would be the perfect cover-up to sacrifice these people. And they dying from overdoses. But we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about that. Don't worry about it. Don't even worry about it. Now, let's talk about the synchronicity that she has with Kobe Bryant. With us being in the year of Kobe, 24, then adding up 2024, you get 8. Both of the numbers that he wore in his career. So now fast forward, we're in the year 24 like Kobe. Remember last year when all the sacrifices, and they still do, as you can see. But remember Skull and Bones. Remember we was in the year of Skull and Bones last year and everything was connected to Skull and Bones. Well, now, this year, everything is going to be connected to Kobe Bryant. Right? With the sacrifice, whether he's really dead or whether he's really not. The energy harvested from that will live on forever and ever. As long as we have social media reminding us of these people's dying. They will always harvest energy from the Kobe Bryant ritual, right? So, breaking down, I'm losing my voice, all this yelling. But, Enchanting was born on the 135 date numerology, just like Kobe Bean Bryant equals 135. Now, let's continue. Because also, breaking down her date numerology as well, another way. It also equals 126, which happens to be the same day that Kobe died, January 26th. And then, just today, on 12/6, now we hear about Jerry West passing away. So look for that video as well. That video is coming too as well. But come on. Because Enchanting was 26 years old at the time of her passing. Just like rapper equals 26 in Chaldean. Bryant equals 26. Jordan. So Jordan and Bryant both equal 26 as well. This is why we have these synchronicities with Kobe Bryant. And we have these synchronicities with Michael Jordan, right? This stuff doesn't just stay in sports. It doesn't just stay in sports. It's all around entertainment. But come on. Right? Even she was born on 26 date numerology. But come on. Now, let's bring a strong Kobe connection to the table. Because Gucci Mane's artist passed away 8 months and 1 day before Gucci Mane's birthday. When his real name, Roger Davis, equals 81. Now, if you understand Kobe, then you understand the connection right here with the number 81. Interesting enough, with Gucci Mane's real name, Roger Davis, equaling 81 as well. Well, that's very interesting. Because Kobe Bean Bryant equals 81 as well. which resembles his 81 points that he scored in his 666th game of his career. Right? And now we have these same parallels with Gucci Mane's sacrifice. And wow, look at that. I didn't even know that when I chose this picture, but she's wearing a coat. She's wearing a jacket, a denim jacket that says 181. But come on. Another synchronicity to Kobe. Breaking down Gucci Mane's birth date numerology. Gucci Mane was born on 113 date numerology, just like Kobe Bryant equals 113, just like Michael Jordan equals 113. This is why this sacrifice includes these people. This is why this sacrifice includes these individuals. It's all synchronized all around the table. And this is why I say I don't know how. This is why I say I don't know how this is being done. It seems like an algorithm. It just seems like an algorithm at this point. It seems like an algorithm that people's lives are being moved on. And it's almost like it's already written that Gucci Mane was going to make a sacrifice. And it was already written that she was going to be the sacrifice. You see what I'm saying? That's how it's starting to seem to me. But come on. Right? Because we know the number 113 is the number for dishonesty. Right? You can see all these words that deal with deception. Not honest, dishonest. Not factual, not true. All these things equal 113. Even the number for dishonesty itself, writing that phrase, it equals 113. So knowing that, it's very interesting that Shannon Nicole Larry, Enchanting's whole name, her birth given name, equals 311, the reflection of 113. And what did they say she died from? An overdose. Even accidental overdose equals 311. The same numbers as her real name, Channing Nicole Larry. And this is how they said she died, by an overdose. 113. Deception. What is the deception? Who's the deception? Gucci Mane, born on 113 date numerology. So he's the main culprit here. He's where this deception is coming from. The deception is coming right out his mouth. Well, let's continue. Right? Another Kobe / Michael Jordan connection. His most recent album, Gucci Mane. The evil Gucci. Because I don't even think that's the real one. Evil Gucci twin dropped the album on October 17th. 10/17 day, right? Makes sense, right? Well, that's very interesting because his most recent album to the day that his artist passed away is a span of 238 days. Just like Michael Jordan equals 238. But look at this. That's also the day that Kobe was born, the 23rd of August. Come on, man. Michael Jordan wore the number 23. Kobe wore the number 8. Come on. So now you see now what I mean by that, what I meant by the Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant connection. It's undeniable. It's undeniable. So let's continue with these last two slides. Now, Enchanting's next birthday that she won't see. And also, Yale University's birthday is on the 121st day of Enchanting's death, just like blood sacrifice equals 121 and Satanists equals 121 as well. Even looking at Gucci's birthday, Gucci's artist died on the 121st day of Gucci's age, blood sacrifice. This was Gucci's blood sacrifice. This was the evil Gucci blood sacrifice. This is why they don't just kill Gucci off. They just gonna clone him, run his ass through the copy machine. And they using him to collect bones. Might as well call him the bone collector. Remember that rapper Bone Collector? He collecting skull and bones. He collecting these skull and bones. He collecting these bones for the skulls. Y'all watch that movie, The Skulls, if y'all haven't already. But this is what these people are put in place to do. It's collect the bones. Once y'all sign y'all names on that dotted line, it's only a matter of time. You signed your fate. You signed your destiny. You signed your destiny. Look at how she looking, man. Look at her face. Look at her face in this picture. A picture worth 1,000 words. Look at her face. Look at how she looking. But that's all. Oh, one more thing. Look at that 369. Look at that 369 down there. But also, the day that she got signed, man, this is her very first post on Instagram where she announced to the world that she had just signed to 1017 Records. She passes away 207 weeks after that, just like her first and last name, man, Channing Larry. Channing Larry equals 207. And she died 207 weeks after she signed the deal. Come on, man. These folks signing their tickets. They signing their death note. When them folks sign that, when they sign that deal, they signing their death note. Watch that. Watch the anime Death Note. It's going to be the exact time, the exact date. It's already going to be there. But y'all let me know what y'all think about this, man. Appreciate y'all for all the love. Appreciate y'all for all the support. And I'm out.